Welcome, everyone, to Our Lady of the Assumption Church here in Ventura, California. We are glad that you can join us today on the sixth Sunday of Easter, but most especially, too, on this wonderful day where we celebrate the gift of our mothers. You know, the mother's love is a wonderful gift because it just reminds us of an unconditional love, which is what we celebrate today in this special liturgy, that we are reminded that it is the love of the Father for the Son, Father Creator, Jesus, His Son, our Redeemer, that allows that great love to grow forth. And so today, as we gather on this wonderful Sunday celebration, that we are offering to one another the gift of unconditional love that we first received from God. That's almost an impossibility for humans, but nothing is impossible for God. And so let us for a moment prepare ourselves to enter into the sacred mysteries of God's redeeming grace. And may this grace most especially be showered upon our mothers as we give thanks and praise that God has blessed them with children, with family, with the gift of friends, and the gift of love. May the Lord bless us all in this day of grace.
Sleeping and run to the tomb. Come and see, come and see, He is alive. A grave that is empty, a promise fulfilled. God who was with us is here with us still. He is here, He is here, He is alive. Alleluia, love is alive.
Welcome and happy Mother's Day to all who join us today for the celebration of the sacred liturgy. And may God's blessings and peace be ours in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The grace, the peace, and the love of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
As we join in our prayer, let us for a moment acknowledge the great gifts that the Lord offers to us, most especially the unconditional love of a God who brings us to life and desires that that life be enriched and fulfilled through prayer, through works of service, and most especially by our being one with the Lord and one another. Let us offer our prayer this day for the goodness and the mercy of God to flow into us. Acknowledging our sinfulness, we turn to the Lord as we say together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray that the presence of God's loving grace will be in our life every day and every moment. Grant, Almighty Father, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let us now prepare ourselves to be attentive to the word of God that we proclaim for us. But please note, we are using the first scripture from the sixth Sunday of the Easter season, and the last two readings, the second reading and the gospel, will come from the seventh Sunday of the Easter season. That is because of the arrival of Ascension Thursday, which we will celebrate next Sunday.
A A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him and, falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Revealed to the nations his saving power. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won a victory for him, his holy arm. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. Salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. A
reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, if God so loved us, we must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet, if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testify that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God, and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
to you, and your hearts will rejoice. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Lifting his eyes up to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me, and I guarded them, and none of them was lost except the son of destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them, because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I sent them into the world, and I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It is our greatest desire to see God, to know that God is with us, that God's presence is evident. And in the seeking, we desire then to find. In our scriptures today, we are greatly reminded that the great love of God is a revelation of God's presence. And that Jesus Christ was born into the world to bring healing to that separation between ourselves and God. It is to unite us. And Jesus often said, I have come to give you peace. I have come to give you life, that you live it to the full. And the fullness of that life is to know God and to be known by God. And our scriptures today then keep reminding us of this power of love to reveal us into that great mystery of what God is, if not love. That is the Gospel of John's primary sentence, God is love. And therefore, since love is a manifestation of God, it is far beyond anyone's own possession. It isn't as if only Catholics or only Christians know God's love. It is a gift given to all of creation, but most especially to human beings, because it was through Jesus, that great revelation then of the Father's love. And isn't that what Jesus is often saying to us, most especially, Father, I have come to share with you the gift of your creation. And to us, Jesus says, if you see me, you see the Father. When Thomas asked the question, what is the way? Jesus' response was what? I am the way, the truth, and the life. Those who come to me will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. What a marvelous desire that is, something so present and so evident to us, and yet it is still a great mystery that we are seeking and desiring all the days of our life. You know, on this Mother's Day, what a greater way to reflect upon that great mystery of God's love to us, but through our mothers. Mothers aren't perfect. And yet, they reveal to us in that great gift of how Jesus reveals his love for us, that it is through that great offering of oneself. What greater gift does a mother offer but life to her children? What greater gift? And all the ways that a mother generates that life to her children, through sacrifice, a sacrificial loving, through a generosity of loving, sleepless nights, longing for her children to be together, the desire that children will be happy. Isn't that what a mother desires? It is so simple, but it is lifelong. Lifelong. That a mother will always be saying things like, oh, this is nice, but wouldn't it be great if the others could be here with us? Or just gathering together in family events and a mother knowing that all of her children are with her and life is good. It is that longing for health, for safety, security, that is always in a mother's heart. And a mother always worrying about her children, no matter how old they are, worrying and hoping that they are happy and fulfilled. I guess you never shake that as a mother. But why would you? Because you have given your heart and your life for the children that you have born. And until the day a mother dies, she's always praying that her children will be fulfilled. Isn't that a taste of the ultimate gift of what God's love for us is about? You know, I think of my own mother. She would gather us around the Sunday table. As a working mother, she desired her children to be fed and nourished. And I always remember the fact that our Sunday dinner would always reappear on Tuesday or Wednesday because we couldn't eat it all in one meal and one sitting. I remember her saying, "The reason I work is so that you can have a Catholic education and that we can periodically go back east to Philadelphia to visit with her side of the family." That was her one purpose, to work so hard along with my father. But that was her gift to us. That was her gift to herself, that together we would then know all of our family members. But it was her sacrifice. And we never think of our mothers as being people. And yet I remember on the day that she retired from her job, she worked at a local military installation here, and that at her retirement party, who showed up with the commander of the military base? And I thought, why is he here? My mother's a secretary. Until I realized what kind of secretary she was and for whom she worked. And that the commander came to the party because they worked with each other. But this is my mother. But I realized, no, this was my mother. And she had a very important role to play. We often don't think of our mothers as people. We just think of them as our mother. And yet, they have a very special role, not only in our own lives, but in the lives of others. And that is what we celebrate on this very special day, because they are a reflection of divine love. And in that reflection of divine love, the words of our scriptures take root. And the word of our scriptures reveal to us then that a mother's love is unconditional and it's everlasting. That a mother's love is precious and endearing. And that is why we honor them today. We thank them for that gift because they show us, like Jesus, who is our creator, who is the source of love. Isn't that what Jesus shows us today in the scriptures? Jesus leads us to the love of God our Father, to love of God our Creator, to the love of the God who is the source of all love. And in a very human way then, our mothers do the same. So as we celebrate this liturgy today, we pray for our mothers. We pray for all who sacrifice so much for us, who give their life in service, who give their life in dedication, from the mundane things that happen each day in acts of generosity and care, that the kindness, the gentleness, the nurturing love of mothers reveals to us the immense and the unconditional gift of love that comes to us from God. May the gift of Jesus Christ once again strengthen our mothers. May the gift of divine grace and love strengthen all who parent us to know that God, our Creator, shines upon us always. And when we desire to see and experience the mystery of God's life, we don't have to look too far. That our seeking really is seen in how we love one another. And wasn't that the great desire of Jesus for us? When we love one another, whether it's mothers or fathers or brothers or sisters or friends, then we see the face of God. This time, we ask that the mothers who are joining with us will bow their heads in prayer as we ask God to send his blessings upon them. Good and gracious God, we thank you today for the gift of motherhood brought to perfection in your holy mother, Mary. We ask you to bless all mothers who show your face to the world through their love. We ask you to comfort those who bear the pain of losing a child and for those with whom motherhood is a broken dream. Bless with your peace those who mourn the loss of their mothers or suffer wounds from a mother's imperfections. Bless all the women who share a mother's love with those who are not their children. Give us a spirit of gratitude for those who have been mothers to us and help us, the children of their bodies and of their hearts, return the love they have so graciously given. We offer this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. And so together now, let us profess this faith we share. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. With concern for the needs of our world and faith in God's healing and saving power, let us bring our petitions before the Lord.
For the church, may we whom Jesus called friends remain in his love and be instruments of love and healing to all the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our nation and around the world, may we always remember and enact Christ's command to love one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers and those inscribed in our Mother's Day novena, that God will watch over them, bless them with every good gift, and fill their hearts with peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers, for all recently initiated into the church, may the new life they experience in Christ continue to bring them joy throughout this Easter season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, may they receive the Lord's healing touch, especially Benita Colitti, Jan Perrone, Deacon Don Gaff, Deacon Tom Halliwell, Deacon Matthew Van Nuyen, Layla Messaker, Bennett Mariag, and Victoria Polikin. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of all who have died, especially Danilo Cuenca and Eruistina Salazar, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the needs and intentions of Carol Bonner, Linda Ramirez, Christina Wright, Marceline Crusen, Mary Fuete, and the Victoria family. The intentions of all our parishioners and the repose of the souls of Marie Abado, Patrick Ferraioli, and Elena Castro, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those intentions not spoken, which we place upon the altar of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful God, we thank you for the blessings you bestow upon us each day. Please hear our prayers that we might reverently care for all you have made and remain always in your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. As we have heard the word of God proclaimed for us, and as we desire now to put the good news into action, just a few reminders. This weekend is a second collection for the Cardinal McIntyre Fund for Charity. This fund provides emergency help to those who are in need and was a source of help to those who were affected by the Thomas Fire and by the pandemic. We thank you for your generosity in contributing to the Cardinal McIntyre Fund. As we begin to open up the parish more and more during these days, we are desiring to welcome all of you back to attendance here at liturgies. We have masses here in the church during the weekdays, and because of the numbers of people who are arriving, we're having mass out on the plaza and in the parking lot. There are still plenty of seats available for those who wish to attend, and also you can listen to mass in your cars, and we have a radio station that you can tune into so you can hear more clearly the mass being prayed. But I'm just asking that those who are feeling more and more comfortable feel free to return to coming to the Eucharist and celebrating mass with us on Sundays and during the weekdays when we celebrate Mass here in church at 6:30 and 8 a.m. And let us now prepare the altar for the great celebration of the Eucharist. Gifts are prepared. Let us join together and pray that our sacrifice will be blessed by God, our Heavenly Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and the glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with these sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly hosts with angelic choirs sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, with all the clergy and all who serve you in Christian ministries. Remember also all of our brothers and our sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of the Assumption, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As a united family in faith, we gather our prayers together as with one voice we proclaim, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you. My peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace with you.
Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
And behold, the body and blood of the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, how blessed are those invited to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
And may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. The act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Eucharist. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me from being separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And just a reminder that on this Mother's Day, we will begin a novena of Masses for mothers. So if you wish to enroll mothers that you know into our novena, please feel free to contact our front office or go to our website where you can include the names of these mothers into our novena of Masses, as we have here on the altar, a little basket with all the names of people that we wish to remember during these 9 days of prayer. And let us pray that our mothers will be blessed this day with great hugs and with great love. So may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may God's blessings be upon us now and always. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace to reflect the love of God.
Thanks be to God.